Hello children, today we are going to see multiplication using halving and doubling. Here, what does it mean? You are going to do one of the factors, you will make it half, and the other factor you are going to make it doubles. Okay, and let's see how the method works. See the question given here. You have to multiply 37 into 35. Okay, now first thing is that you need to choose any one of the factor in the question to make it half, and the other factor you are going to make it double. Okay, suppose I choose 37 to make it half, and this column I will use to make it doubles. Okay, now how you are going to proceed. So 37, as it is an odd number, you are going to write only the quotients. Okay, you need to ignore the remainders. That is, when 37 divided by 2, when you do 18, you will get it as the quotient, and 1 is the remainder which you are going to ignore it. Okay, now what is half of 18? That is 9. Again, this is an odd number. So you are going to write only the quotient, or you may do it as subtract 1 from this number. That is 9 minus 1 is 8. And what is half of 8? That is 4. What is half of 4? That is 2. What is half of 2? That is 1. So bring this column up to 1. Now simultaneously you have to make the other column multiplied by 2. So now which numbers you will get? See, this is 35. 35 double is 70. 70 double is 140. 140 double, that is 280. 280 double, that is 560. And 560 double, so you will have it as 120. So up to here, I hope that you are clear. Now, you need to see that the rows combining the even numbers in the halves column. Once again, the numbers combining the even numbers in the halves column. So that is, here you have the column for halves. So wherever you have the even numbers, you are going to cancel out those rows. So here this is an even number, so I will cancel out this row. This is an even number, so I will cancel out this row also. This is an even number, so I will cancel out this row also. Okay, now the numbers in the doubles columns corresponding to these are added, and you will get the final product. So here I need to add the rest of the numbers. So here I will have it as 5. Then this is 3 plus 2, 3 plus 2 and plus 4, that is, you will have 9. Okay, now this is 1 and 1, that is 2, and this is 1. Okay, so your answer for this question, that is 37 into 35, comes to 1295. Let us see second question. Say you are asked to multiply 24 into 15. So I will write the two numbers. See to it that you may choose any of the numbers given. It's not necessary that 24 only. You can alter the numbers also. This column you can, means 15 you can take it to make it half also, and 24 you can make it to double also. Whatever is easier for you, you can proceed the same. So here this column I choose to make it half, and this column I choose to make it double. So half of 24, that is 12. Half of 12, that is 6. 6 half is 3. 3 is an odd number. So 3 minus 1, that is 2. And 2 divided by 2, that is 1. Or you can think in a way that remainders you need to ignore. Now here, this is the column where you have to multiply by 2. So here what happens? 15 double 30, 30 double 60, 60 double 120, and 120 double 240. Now, then after you have to cross out the rows where you have even number in the column of halves. So here this is an even number. So here I need to cross out. This is an even number, cross out. This is an even number, cross out. What is left out? So here this is 0. 4 plus 2 is 6 and 2 plus 1 is 3. So your answer is 360. Right? Let me take up one more question. So here suppose you are asked to multiply 26 and 18. So here I will make two columns, 26 and 18. This column is for half and this column is meant for doubling. So here I will go on dividing by 2. So 26 half, 13, odd number. So 13 minus 1 is 12. So 12 divided by 2, that is you will have 6. 6 divided by 2, that is 3, and 3 is an odd number. So 3 minus 1, that is 2. 2 divided by 2, that is 1. Okay, and now here we will do multiply by 2. So 18 double 36, 36 double 72, 72 double 144, and 144 double 288. Right? And now I will cross out the numbers where you have even numbers in the column of halves. So here 26 is an even number. I will cross out this row. 6 is an even number. I need to cross out this row also. Now what is left out in the doubles column, I need to add them up. So 6 and 4, 10, and 8, 18. So here this is 1 carryover. So 3 plus 1, 4, plus 4, 8, plus 8, 16. So now this is 1 carryover. 1, 1, 2, and 2, 4. So this is 4, 68. Okay. Now let me do one more question, last question. So here, suppose I am giving both the numbers to be odd. Say 13 into 15. So here, let me take this number, 13 to make it half and 15 to make it double. So half of 13, that is as 13 is an odd number. So I will do 13 minus 1, that is 12. So 12 half, that is 6. Or you may think that remainders you need to ignore. So 6 twos are 12 and 1 remainder you have ignored. And here 6 half, that is 3, and again an odd number. So 3 minus 1 is 2. 2 divided by 2 is 1. Whenever you get 1, you need to stop. Now doubles column, 15 twos are 30, 30 twos are 60, 60 twos are 120. And now I will cancel out the rows where even numbers you have in the halves column. So here no, here this is an even number, cross out. Here both the numbers are odd, so you need to keep it like that only. Now we will add up the numbers, whatever is left out in doubles column. So here 5, and this is 6 plus 1, 7 plus 2, 9, and this is 1. So you get the final answer. Fine. Now let's see how this method works. Or does it work always? Yes, it works always. Now to understand this, let's see an array 4 into 7. So here you can see four rows are given and in each row seven dots are given. So this represents 4 into 7. Okay, now the question, the method which we are saying, that is half and the doubles. Okay, so here these four rows I divide it into two, okay, and I will rearrange them. So this part will come over here. Okay, so now how the figure will look? It will look like this, isn't it? So this part you have brought over here. Does it change the multiplication? No. The total number, will it change if you have brought this part over here? No. Right? So here the method will work always. You may try it out with many more questions. Thank you.